Today is a very exciting day. I'm packing to head to Michigan with Ian, and I'm gonna vlog the whole thing. Shit. Holy shit. I should definitely unload those.
Hi, this is Ian.
I'm on
the call right now.
So, we're headed to Michigan to the same class that I got to go to last year. Pretty excited this year. My dad's gonna hop in and take the class with us, so that should be fun. This trip to Michigan last year was like really the first time that I tried to get out and kind of like start to spread the word about Range Fox a little bit. It just so happened that the crew that was there was a bunch of super solid dudes. Ohio 9x19, my boy Tyler, good dude. DJ Beck, Derek's a solid guy putting us up for the weekend. And I don't think Ryan's gonna participate in the class, but he might show up, stop in for a little bit, and hang out. Another super solid dude, really grateful to have met him last year. Almost just got on the interstate going the wrong way. Just need a little. Yeah. Let's get to know each other a little bit, huh? And, oh, shit. We're here. Hey.
Why? Coronavirus.
No, I'm chopping up because this is how we do the ground beef. I have a blender. Not a blender, a shredder.
I don't have a what's the word I'm looking for? Put your blood bass and speakeasy jujitsu. Like murderous rhymes tight from genuine craft. Check the print. Swear veterans, walk the lettering, slow moving and fusing. All right, Dad, when do we have to be at the airport tomorrow?
We would preferably try to be at the airport 1 hour prior, so 6:20, which means that we would have to leave here at 05. It takes an hour and 20 minutes exact to get to the airport.
Okay. 5 in the morning?
Yeah. Bitch, you're not even fucking driving. I don't want to hear it. As my fucking career is ruined.
Fucking sick of me shoving the camera in your face after this. If you're not already. So I'm just forced to never have a fucking normal job again. Kind of like
That's why I like
Barker.
That's why I like when this whole thing happened. I'm like, well, I gotta figure something out because I'm literally fucked because I can't get it. I mean, unless I work some fucking third shift fucking shit job, there's no other way. So
the point of no return.
Definitely the point of no return.
I think there comes a point. For me, it was like 3 years into working for myself.
Yeah.
I just like, you just wake up one morning and you're like, well, I'll literally never go back to working for somebody else again.
Yep.
It's just not possible.
But I mean, we all know at least one person, either currently or in a past life, where they're not alive. They're just existing.
There's a difference between breathing and being alive.
Yep. Are you just going to float through life or are you actually going to live it?
What do we have by way of coffee? Is there any? Yeah! I never thought I'd be happy about Keurig coffee. I don't think that looking at a camera is ever gonna get to be comfortable. Especially when it is this big and you're walking around the airport with like, looks like a dead squirrel on top of a laptop. With like octopus tentacles coming off the bottom of it. Your paperwork. Can't find the car. Off to a good start.
I mean, at least we landed safely.
We still have to fly back. What are you doing?
Woodward's?
No, Woodward is a street. Great Lakes Coffee Roasters, I think.
3965 Woodward Ave, D motherfucking Troy.
That's the one. Sir, do you have any e-cigarettes in your bag or knives or ammunition? No. Do you? This car
has
an analog clock in it.
Fishburne's fucking brother.
That
shitty airport breath.
Is it different than regular shitty breath?
Yeah. Because usually at the airport you have to get up stupid early. And you've been awake for a while. And you probably had a couple cups of coffee. And coffee makes your fucking breath stink. So yeah.
Do you have solid-state hard drive?
Right now, we are going to be extorting Best Buy here to get the curbside pickup faster than it's ready. The order's not ready yet, but we will fix.
Hello.
Here for pickup?
Place mobile order for a removable hard drive. It says it is.
Yep, so did you get an email saying it was ready for pickup?
No. 20 minutes. Yep. You had 20 minutes.
Should we go get food while we wait?
What do you want to get for food?
There's a Panera Bread right around the corner.
Oh man.
You got that, boys?
You don't have to argue with me about the virtue of Dairy Queen. I'm down.
I might barf though.
I'm definitely gonna barf. I feel sick.
You're gonna drop that.
I'm not gonna drop it. We just ate $70 worth of Panera Bread. $70 worth of Panera.
And then we just had Dairy Queen.
And then Dairy Queen.
While blasting Mob Deep in the Chrysler 300.
I hope they got two bathrooms in there.
Good morning. Good morning, world.
I wish there was a table.
Oat milk. They like suckle the tea to the oat to get the milk out.
You guys have any cow milk?
You have any pig milk?
What do baby pigs drink if they don't drink pig milk?
Any flamingo milk?
You know how you can...
You have any, you have any pigeon milk?
You know how you can like go into get, like gas stations and buy like alligator jerky? You know, or like ostrich jerky? I'm going to start like a third-rate, cheap company that just bottles up various exotic milks. It'd be like fucking Noah's Ark, but everything's hooked up to like leakers. Just extract the milk out of...
I'm realizing that I haven't narrated much of anything in a productive sense since we've been doing this. So
yeah, I mean, you haven't explained anything. It's just random clips of shit happening.
Yeah, up until this point, it's just been the chaos of flying with Ian. He's like a child.
You're the child.
And then...
He almost made us late for the flight, by the
way. I did not almost make us late for the flight.
Just so history knows.
I did not almost make us late for the flight. We stood in line all day. We were plenty of time to stand in line all day.
Just so history knows.
So up until this point in the deal, we've been basically just suffering each other's existence, trying to make it into the murder shack of a hotel. And now we're on our way to the range for the first day of this here Michigan class.
Yep.
This whole deal was supposed to be a little bit of a fuck you to the state of Michigan, especially the tyrannical governor who was forcing people to stay at home.
Gretchen. And
stay afraid.
You're watching this, Gretchen.
But
we ain't afraid.
We stand with the Livingston County Sheriff on this one, and we stood with them a few weeks back when we booked plane tickets. And
yep.
Now it just so happens that the Grand Imperial Gretchen has... permitted her subjects to gather in groups of 10, so this class is no longer quite as much a middle finger to the state, but I wanted to go on record to just be clear that that was kind of the motivation behind a lot of this trip. So Papa Bob is going to join us for the day here. That should be interesting.
Should be.
Hey,
what's going on?
The plate, I figured it was probably you or somebody. I'm grabbing a mower because they didn't get mowed.
Okay. So it's got my feet wet, it's driving me nuts.
had a break for lunch. We did some work from the holster. We did a little bit of lateral movement, a little bit of horizontal movement. And now we're going to finish up with a little Z drill here.
Good.
When I see everybody just jumping to the ground and I start running at them, I know something. I did something wrong.
It's done.
What happened? You saw it though.
Yeah. There it is.
There it is.
Mags. 5,000 rounds to these mags at this.
Your spring is fucking done.
Spring, yeah. Get your finger. I mean, if it's only happening with the mags, then it's the fucking mag.
Boy, get a new fucking gun. Here.
I mean, live round stuck on the ramp.
Which generally, failure to feed is going to be your recoil spring. Yeah, but why would my mags run in yours though?
I started having failure to eject running low recoil ammunition that I didn't know was low recoil ammunition. So all of a sudden my pistol started malfunctioning like every other round. It's a good lesson learned for me. I had never tried to run low recoil ammunition and I never will again. Lunchtime, day two, Rune Nation, Michigan. 3 or 4 more hours to go.
Yep.
And then it's back to mom and dad's house for a little
soiree.
Yup. Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
Oof. Do you need a blanket? I just found out that Ian doesn't eat pineapple on his pizza, so I no longer trust this man.
Pepperoni with the breadstick.
Obviously you're doing something positive, so yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely, it is on. We're just gonna make a little YouTube video of our trip here to Michigan, participating in a class here in Fall.
I wanted to tell you that lady you were talking to, the woman that came up here, she owns the place. She's the owner.
Oh shit. She's like, what are you doing? I hope we didn't get you folks in trouble.
No, not at all.
Okay.
Well, as long as you're not like a health inspector.
No, God no.
No.
Are you kidding
me?
Yeah, it doesn't look like me. I guarantee you that. Yeah.
Are you sure we're not sure?
Well, him and me. Yeah.
Okay. Can I ask why? I'm the owner.
Yeah. We're just making a YouTube video. We're here visiting for a class.
Okay. You're not like gonna fly on a follower
page. No, God no.
Where are you from?
I live in Vermont.
How are things over there?
It's actually not that bad.
It's pretty much in Vermont. It's like half of this trip was the fact that we just want to give the middle finger to like the governor of the state, you know, like I hear you. Yeah, well can we elbow bump? Yeah. Yeah. I grew up in Michigan. My parents still live here, and so part of the reason we came here was because we think that she's a little insane. Anyway.
Really?
Are you serious?
They don't have a problem with what we're doing.
No, the sheriff is like in support in Livingston County. Most of why we're filming this is just to like re-encourage people that there are folks out there with like minds of their own who are doing their own shit.
No.
Absolutely. Yeah. You're like, what the hell is this dude doing? Yeah.
I'm like, they're really nice guys, but I don't need to get.
So he teaches. And I own a business that supports what he teaches. He's a firearms instructor.
Yeah.
Okay. And I own a business that's it's a mobile app for shooting. So it's kind of like a workout app, but for shooting. So we travel around together and go places, whatever. And this class was supposed to get canceled because of everything that's going on here. But we decided we were going to come anyway and just take our chances of what's going on.
Give a middle finger to Gretchen.
And pretty much give a middle finger to Gretchen. And she's up in Traverse City at her house with her family and what. Yeah. So that's the deal behind. Now, if it makes you uncomfortable though, I don't put a damn thing in there about this whole. I mean, if you'd rather.
As long as we're not getting blessed.
No. No. Absolutely not.
that's what it should be when you come to a class. Like, and again, there has to be obviously an establishment between teacher and student, but at the end of the day, I'm not here to berate you, make you feel like shit, and just scream all day. Like, you not only paid good money to be here, you paid the tuition, you paid the ammo, you paid the gas, you paid potentially, you know, some people sometimes fly to my classes, some of you drove, so again, gas or flight, doesn't matter, hotel, food, like all this other stuff on top. So I'm not here to, then you come here and like, by the way, you're a piece of shit. Like, there's literally no rhyme or reason for, in my opinion, any teacher do that. Okay, you're not in an SF pipeline, you're not in the police academy, you're an individual who has a desire to learn and become more better, more confident in your shooting. And as an educator, as a teacher, you should have that ability to get your information across without berating somebody.
We just ate.
Oh, shit.
Turn the lights off first.
Why is my face melting?
And now we're about to spend the night in my niece and nephew's bunk beds again.
Hit this light when you're done, okay?
Okay. I'm not doing anything.
Okay.
Good night.
Nighty night.
Love you.
Too good.
Dad's like, I'm sick of this shit. My favorite pastime is stressing Ian out.
We're gonna be late now.
We are not.
It's 8:02. It takes exactly 28 minutes to get to the range.
And the class starts at 9.
Yeah, I usually get there early to set up.
A half an hour?
This is what I have to deal with. For all of you going to watch this later, this is what I have to deal with every single time.
They literally need to staple 6 paper targets to stands that are already placed out.
Staple your 6 targets. I'm never going to financially recover from this.
Day 2 at the Ruination class in Michigan, and it's pretty hot out here today, so put them shade tents up on the line. Totally suburban America. He's like, I just fill up a garbage can full of water in the driveway and I just shove them in it until they die. He's like, yeah, the little ones, they got tiny little lungs. There's a couple burps and they're gone. I'm like, are you shitting me? He's like, yeah, the worst is when they stick their arms through the cage. Yesterday culminated day 2 of Rune Nation Michigan Edition. And
Rune Michigan.
No police, no Governor Gretchen Whitmore. So that was good. We had a wonderful evening at Mom and Dad's house.
Yep. Fantastic culmination to 2 days in Michigan. Been looking forward to this weekend for 365 days, so it was well worth the wait.
This has become an annual pilgrimage that means more than just the shooting part of the class. It's more about Dairy Queen and
Ritters, right? So that's called Ritters?
We had Ritters one night.
Which is frozen custard, it's not ice cream.
It's different.
It's different, but it's good. It's a good different. Mediterranean pasta last year.
Rice.
Mediterranean rice.
Rice this year, yeah.
Yeah. And grilled salmon.
So, who knows what 2021 holds for Mediterranean cuisine here in Michigan, but we'll be back to find out. Back to the Northeast.
Through the communist TSA and flights through hell to get back.
What Ian doesn't know yet is I snuck a few hot rounds into his rifle case, so.
Sure he did.
We'll see what the boys in blue have to say about that a little later.
Mm-hmm.